Hi, Steph.
Hi, Gary.
How are you?
I'm good. Are you?
Looking well. Today, I'm coming to look at a flat that belongs to my good friend Stefan Sund.
Come on, then, show me around.
I'll show you around.
Stefan is rich, plays polo, likes boats and aeroplanes, private jets, the works.
You remember this from before?
I think it was a bedroom, wasn't it, before?
Yeah, two bedrooms. Underfloor heating, AV system.
I think the quality is way above the normal English standard.
I am looking to buy a new house. At the same time, I want Gary to see this so I can make up my mind later on if I'm renting it or if I'm selling it.
This is the guest suite. We put in impact-resistant glass, soundproofing. It's very, very quiet.
Gives people comfort and security.
Absolutely.
Come on, Gary, let me show you the master bedroom with ensuite.
Wow, lovely.
Slab marble everywhere, underfloor heating.
Fabulous quality.
I spend normally 2-3 nights a week here, working out of my office around the corner. But now, since my daughter wants to come in and spend a year at school in London, I really need a bigger place.
I think it's the best use of space for the space that you have.
So what do you reckon? Should I rent it or sell it?
Not much dividend in renting it, and assuming it's worth £5 million, for argument's sake.
I'm not going to sell it for £5 million.
I'm the agent. I've got to be the one advising you on price.
Yeah.
Well, okay, what do you have in mind, then?
Well, I was thinking at least another million.
We can discuss this, but I think six is a little bit high. What do you want to spend on a house?
About £10 million, not more.
Where do you want to be?
In Mayfair. I want to be as close as possible to this location where I am now.
And then, flexibility? Yes, no, maybe?
Very little. Sure, you can go 50 yards here, 100 yards that way, maybe.
Kind of you. Yeah. Mayfair is an area in London which everybody in the world would know is that the most expensive position on the Monopoly board.
5,000 square feet?
5 to 10,000 square feet.
What?
With parking.
Well, you push sometimes.
I want him to actually do that little bit extra for me. And he can make two commissions in one go. And he only has to take me to dinner once.
Thanks for coming.
Thanks for being loyal as usual. Today we're in Mayfair.
I'm showing Stefan a beautifully modernized house. Although the house is small, it has the advantage of having a planning consent to build about 1,000 square feet below ground.
So when was this done?
This is done very recently. It's done for my client. The quality is superb. This clearly was a garage originally. They've kept the car doors because he likes the idea of putting in a fabulous car in here if he needs to.
Into the kitchen. Gary's suggestion about driving my Ferrari into the kitchen. No, that's a no for me.
This is the TV, but the whole thing opens up. You've got all the storage space behind.
Okay.
It's on an electromagnet.
Cool.
Then you've got all the bits and pieces that you love, double fridge, microwave, solid marble top. Our client's got planning permission to go down below between 800 and 1,000 square feet.
What I look for in a new place is something that I can make my own. Could be building a nice smoking room, something that has a special feeling that I can relate to me that I like.
So this is
the main drawing room, four windows over the front. And you'll notice when we look at the rest of the house that there are windows all the way across the back of the house, which is, as you know, very rare. And he's done it very cleverly with these Chinese shutters.
They've done a good job. Shall we have a look at the rest?
This is the master bedroom.
Very nice.
It's got a row of cupboards over here, and the middle one takes you into a spectacular bathroom.
Oh, that's fantastic. Looks really nice.
What do you think?
I think they've done a nice job. I think it looks beautiful, except for space. I can't really see how I can create space, even if I went down. I'm not sure it really would work for me.
Hello, guys. How are you?
I'm Gary Francesca.
Stefan wants to stay in Mayfair, but today we're in an area of London called St James's.
Feel free to have a look around. If you have any questions, let me know.
We are probably 100 yards as the crow flies from Buckingham Palace.
This is the nice dining room.
Quite rare, actually, to find a house where you have a decent-sized and separate dining room. So you could have some very interesting, and I hope you invite me, dinner parties.
Since our last viewing, Gary sent me some more properties online. He's already told me that it's very difficult to find really what I want in Mayfair. So I should really be looking a little bit further afield.
Kitchen?
marble work surfaces on the same floor as the dining room, very practical. Lots of very good units, huge oven.
Stefan, he's actually my closest friend. It's down to me to find him a lovely home for him and his wife and daughter to live in. I don't want to embarrass myself by not doing so.
Bright master bedroom, it's air-conditioned, and a dressing room and bathroom.
Nice. Carrera marble, nice, but look, then they just have a ceramic tray.
I'm sure you can improve on it yourself, Stefan.
Yeah, I'll rip it out. So this is the media room, then?
It's got the sound systems, but it has a feel of a nice family room. It's very good value, Stefan. 8 million, 5 principal bedrooms, all with bathrooms en suite.
Where do I leave the car? I want to have my car nearby so I can rush off to a polo game or whatever I have. I don't want to have to go somewhere else.
And resident parking won't do? I can get you a
resident parking doesn't, you know, what if I want to leave my Ferrari in the street? Doesn't it work for me?
Hi, Gary.
Hi, Steph.
Good to see you.
You too. I'm in the country today, outside London, at Stefan Sund's Polo Club. We're going to talk about whether he's going to make an offer for the lovely flat in Lancaster Gate.
Well, I've just been exercising this morning. We're playing later on today. I have a game this afternoon. I had to squeeze him in between practices to discuss the properties that we've been seeing.
I was positively surprised by the flat. I thought, you know, it had ticked a lot of the boxes.
And the price?
In order to get the flat to fit my purposes, I would have to put in quite a lot of work, which is going to cost me quite a bit of money. So I can't really see that the price they're asking is going to work. If it sticks within my budget, and you know my budget is 10 million, then I would be interested in pursuing it.
I don't know how far I can get my client down. Initially, he told me he wanted no less than 11 and a half. Then the best thing for me to do is go back to them, see whether they consider something around 10, 10 and a half million.
Otherwise, I wouldn't mind if you came up with some other proposals in the same area.
Which brings me onto the subject of your own flat, and I should be onto it and marketing it pretty quickly now.
From what I've seen you show me so far, I think that we should be able to find something quite soon. So I'll be happy for you to list my flat.
It shows me that he has taken the decision to sell it, so that it means he's probably almost taking the decision to buy Lancaster Gate. So it is very, very positive news as far as I'm concerned.
Thanks again.
Thank you for having me, and perhaps I'll stick around and watch a bit of polo.